This is CNN, home of fake news.
Will the campaign take on the worst situation with coronavirus that we've had to date?
Well, I don't know what you've been paying attention to, Chris, but the president has been taking this problem head on since the very first week of January. That's when the CDC began issuing travel warnings to China and then also screenings at major American airports. And it was by the end of January when the president restricted travel from China, which I would point out again, that is something that we know that Joe Biden would not have done because he called it xenophobic and fear-mongering. Uh-huh. So if Joe Biden had been president at that time, we know that we would be in a worse situation today in this country as a result of that. Uh-huh. And I think there needs to be a greater focus mm-hmm. on some of the good news, which I don't think you guys spend a whole lot of time talking about. Uh-huh. When the president says we've turned a corner, it's because just recently, in just the last few days, the FDA has approved uh-huh. remdesivir, which is a therapeutic and very effective at treating this. We are this close uh-huh. to having a vaccine, which will be distributed in hundreds of millions of doses, and the first ones who will receive the doses will be the most vulnerable in our community.
You're not really listening to me, are you?
Uh-huh.
I mean, I could say anything right now, like you're a complete tool.
Mm-hmm.
But you wouldn't hear it, because you're a freak with a microphone.
Uh-huh.
And if you ask Joe Biden, what would he have done differently mm-hmm. from what President Trump did? He doesn't have an answer. Uh-huh. He can't point to anything. Mm-hmm. His COVID plan is pretty much word for word exactly what President Trump has been doing
okay.
over the course uh-huh. of the last 9 months.
So, Tim,
and the approach is different.
Tim,
President Trump is optimistic. He wants to reopen the country.
Right.
Joe Biden is the candidate of lockdowns.
Right.
That's not where we should head as a country.
All right. I got you. I let you make 6 points there before I cut in.
But we were watching South Korea, excuse me, and China and Italy, and we weren't taking right. action right. when those countries yeah. were right. spiking. Sure.
In a perfect world, it would have been nice to know what was going on there. We didn't. But I believe, Jim, that we acted very, very early in that.
You have to close things down when you are left with no other choice because nothing else is being done and cases are out of control.
Biden's COVID strategy consists of what that Donald Trump hasn't already done? That big thing is, number one, lockdowns, correct? And number two, national mask mandate. Will either one work?
No. In fact, lockdowns and mandatory mask mandates are probably slowing the onset of herd immunity. We want people who are generally healthy to actually contract COVID if they do naturally. If you're under the age of 50, you've got a 99.95 chance of survival.
You have to close things down when you are left with no other choice because nothing else is being done and cases are out of control. That's called science, okay? We don't have a choice. Nobody wants to shut down. You'd be foolish to have to shut down. Everyone is suffering. The question is, what kind of suffering are you going to preference? Economic suffering that you can recover from, or loss of life. Now, going in reverse order, Biden is no different than Trump. Demonstrably false, and you know this from the last debate. He said
no,
several
that's
things.
That's not true at all.
Tim,
Chris.
I let
that's
you
not
speak.
True at all. What would he have possibly done?
I let you speak. Now you do the same, or this will be really short. I promise you that. So, in the last debate, the vice president, the former VP, said, I would be doing a lot more of coordinating funds to help the schools do what they need to do to open and businesses need to do to open and to work with those communities. Now, we hear that echoed by Republican and Democratic governors all over this country. The vaccine, you are correct. We will have a vaccine. You will have doses, but not anywhere near close enough for it to be any kind of cure. Remdesivir has been approved for people who are in acute distress. My brother, let me tell you this. I hope you never need it. Not just that you never get COVID, which I hope for you and your family, but that you never need remdesivir because you will be in a state of near pneumonia and you don't want to be there. So the idea that remdesivir is a cure, it is at best a treatment for people who are in extremis. So that's that. Biden was against the China thing. His campaign says time and time again, he was not against the move. He's about being against how the president spoke about it. Now, what
oh,
was...
Oh, come on.
But hold
you
on, Tim.
Don't buy
and,
that,
Tim,
do
and
you?
Here's the question.
On January 30th, the World Health Organization declared the Chinese coronavirus a global health emergency. President Trump acted immediately, announcing new travel restrictions on China. Joe Biden, he got it wrong. The very same day the China travel restrictions were announced, Biden attacked President Trump for acting irrationally.
This is no time for Donald Trump's record of hysterical xenophobia, and fear-mongering to lead the way instead of science.
Biden tweeted the same attack about xenophobia again, and again, and again. As late as March 26, the Biden campaign still refused to support President Trump's action. Biden's staff would only say travel restrictions could be warranted. Finally, 2 months after President Trump's decision, Biden's staff claimed he supported them all along. They want to rewrite history, but no amount of spin can cover up the fact that Joe Biden got it wrong and President Trump got it right when American lives were at stake.
He said it was xenophobic and fear-mongering, Chris, and it took them 2 months to even address it. Your network is the one who broke the story about how he had reversed himself.
I will give you that Biden was against it. Now, he says they weren't, but I'll give you the point, and here's why.
I shouldn't have closed the border. Well, that's obvious.
Do you want to respond to that quickly, Vice President Biden? Okay.
If you want to hold down Biden for being against that, where the hell has the president been for months of doing nothing additional to help an emerging crisis such that his own chief of staff today said something I've never heard, Tim, and never of you. We can't control the virus.
Okay, that was a long soliloquy here.
I just matched your points, brother. Go ahead. Don't waste your time.
Listen, Chris, your own brother, the governor of New York, mm-hmm. said that every time he turned to the administration, the federal government was there with everything that
he did not say that.
That every time he turned to the administration, the federal government was there with everything
he did not say that.
He has been responsive to New York and responsive to New York's needs, and he's done it quickly and he's done it efficiently. I've literally had conversations with him in the morning where he turned around a decision by that afternoon. And he has really responded to New York's needs.
And Howard, he has been good in delivering for New York. He has delivered for New York.
I can tell you he is fully engaged on trying to help New York. He's being very creative and very energetic. And I thank him for his partnership. So I believe he's doing what he has to do. And I respect him for it. I respect him for it.
Your own brother, the governor of New York, mm-hmm. said that every time he turned to the administration, the federal government was there with everything
he did not say that.
Do I have faith in the president? Look, what the federal government did working with states, as I just said, was a phenomenal accomplishment. These were just extraordinary efforts and acts of mobilization. And the federal government stepped up and was a great partner, and I'm the first one to say it. We needed help, and they were there.
Everything and that is not what happened.
Yes, he absolutely did.
He said, I went to the federal government. Yes. They helped me with things. They did not help with everything. They're still not helping.
The president did help New York. He sent the Army Corps of Engineers to build the Javits Center. Thank you very much. He sent 4,000 ventilators. Thank you very much. The Army Corps of Engineers came and helped us build alternative facilities. Thank you very much.
Ed, my brother what?
Listen,
keep talking
your
about
brother it. Predicted your brother predicted a ventilator shortage. He said he needed 40,000 ventilators or people would die. That shortage never materialized because the president engaged the private sector and the government to create the equipment, the PPE, the gowns, the gloves, and the ventilators that we need. And
FEMA is sending us 400 ventilators. 400 ventilators. I need 30,000 ventilators. You want a pat on the back for sending 400 ventilators? What are we going to do with 400 ventilators when we need 30,000 ventilators?
Now, Trump was pilloried for questioning whether New York really needed 30 to 40,000 ventilators. Well, Cuomo, as you remember, was adamant that his state needed them. But according to the latest estimates from the IHME model, the state's ventilator needs peaked 2 weeks ago at not 30 or 40,000, but 5,986.
So listen, Chris, I find it curious, speaking of your brother, you're going to ask me these self-righteous questions and talk about people taking it seriously. Does this look like a couple of guys who were taking it seriously?
Is it true that when you were having the test administered, you inhaled and the doctor's finger went all the way up your nose and got stuck and had to be released with a tool? Is it true that this was the swab that the nurse was actually using on you?
You had your brother on for the Cuomo Brothers Comedy Hour. They're joking about the size of the Q-tip that you would need for his nose
yeah,
to get
I did.
A test.
It was funny
Does
as hell.
Does this sound like somebody who was taking it very seriously?
Tim, let
now,
me tell you.
The president has done this every
Tim,
step of the way.
Tim, I got you.
Every step of the way, and he's done everything
Tim.
That states had
All
asked
All right, so
for.
Let's deal with that. That's not true. And you know it, but you decide
it
to say what you want to say.
It absolutely is true.
Tim,
he sent
is
a hospital ship
Tim,
to New York that,
Tim,
that they really didn't adequately
They didn't
use.
Need it. And
the
thank God they didn't need it. Tim, listen,
there
you are
go.
Not going to flood the zone
provided
on
it,
this
even
show.
Though it was
Tim,
extra assistance.
I'm telling you, I'll cut you off. You're not going to flood the zone on this show. I'm wowed by what you did. And more importantly, I'm wowed by how you did it. This was very hard. I know it's not over, but obviously I love you as a brother. Obviously I'll never be objective. Obviously I think you're the best politician in the country.
The best politician
Unbelievable.
In the country.
And again, this is the governor who condemned old people to death in nursing homes. And then his own brother never once ever asked him about it.
And had the worst outbreak in the entire country.
This is propaganda. I mean, how could he say that to with so many old people, so many elderly people who lost their lives? And
Tim,
extra assistance
I'm telling
case.
You, I'll cut you off. You're not going to flood the zone on this show. Now, you took your swing. It missed. So now let's discuss. That's the best you got? Is that my brother diddidn't take COVID seriously? Are you kidding yourself that I
well,
made fun
I mean,
with him in a time of such
about
acute
sending COVID
distress?
Positive patients into he's, nursing homes?
First of all,
first,
he never sent
that?
Any, and you know that. You know that New York State is 46th
no,
out of
well,
50th.
Someone did,
but here's what you know most of all.
I
you
thought
can't
he just wrote
even
a book
talk.
About leadership,
Tim,
though.
I know
that
he
means
did.
Taking responsibility.
You should read it, brother, and let me tell you why. You won't even talk about the president. You want to talk about my brother because you are coming from a place of weakness. You are in the middle of a pandemic.
No,
and
I want
your
to talk
president.
About, I want to talk about people turning COVID and the coronavirus crisis into a political weapon, which is what CNN does all
your
day long.
Your president,
it's what Joe Biden
my
and the Democrats
president,
do.
Told
yeah,
people
absolutely,
for
they,
months. Tim, spin doesn't cut it on this show, pal. And here's why. Look at the numbers. This president has said time and time again, masks don't matter.
Right now in the United States, people should not be walking around with masks.
You're sure of it? Because people are listening really
no,
closely to this.
Right now, people should not be walking. There's no reason to be walking around with a mask.
And it turns out this guy was lying.
Time and time again, we're rounding the corner. It's going away.
Okay.
Any spike that happens
so
leaves.
Let me ask you a question.
We've never been in worse shape.
What?
He won't do the testing.
So
he says go back
listen,
to school.
Chris,
he won't help with schools.
You are advocating. What you are doing is advocating a complete and total shutdown. The only actual way to prevent any spread of the coronavirus is to have no human interaction whatsoever.
Not true.
So are you seriously
not true.
Are you seriously advocating
not true.
Having people being locked in their homes for, what, 6 months?
Not true.
12 months, 18 months?
Not true.
In China, they welded people's doors shut. Chris.
Not us.
Is that what you're
Doesn't
advocating?
Need to happen.
Listen, President Trump wants people to be safe. Take precautions. Absolutely.
Please.
But we cannot
Look at his
allow
rallies.
Ourselves to be locked back into
as
the basement.
As handsome as Tim
again,
is, while
Joe
he talks,
Biden,
run
listen,
the video of the rallies
the health
today.
Problems, every medical, every health expert will tell
Do
you.
Do what I said. Run the video of the rallies today.
A severe economic downturn would cause health problems on its own, above and beyond, unassociated with what the coronavirus causes.
That is
It'll cause health
nonsense.
Anxiety problems in children.
That is nonsense.
It's absolutely
what calls,
true. Where, Chris,
what
where call, I live
hey, Tim,
in Fairfax
Tim,
County,
listen,
Virginia.
How many weak points do you want to make before I get in? Now, in terms of anxiety and ancillary health effects that
you're
we're seeing from people.
You're not interested in having an actual conversation.
Well, Tom,
first,
you're not
you're
letting
not.
Me talk. I
you're
let
not.
You talk. You don't let me speak. Come on now. You can do better
yeah,
than this. I've seen you before.
Here.
Listen, no, no
this
way.
Is not, this
I'll
is
send
not,
you the
no,
word count.
This is not an
I'll,
interview, Chris.
I'll
this
send
is
you the
lecturing.
Word count. I'll send you the word count. I'm not trying to lecture. I'm trying to rebut what you put out there. You're the one who lectured me with the picture of my brother and I, which was very funny. And at a time that the country was hurting.
I don't think it was that funny.
And the country needed a picture of my brother and I, which was very funny. And at a time that the country was hurting.
I don't think it was that funny.
And the country was hurting.
I don't think it was that funny.
And the country needed comfort. Oh, I don't know that you're a good judge of humor because you think what the president is saying at these rallies is funny. I've seen you laugh about it. And he's telling people to mock the fact that they're putting their own health at risk time and again. This was today, brother. In the middle of a pandemic, they have no masks on. He never said anything different. He's putting these people in these positions, and he has no plan to do anything better. No, I'm about a president sending the right message. I'm about a president sending the right message and giving states what they need to fight a pandemic. Because I did the wrong thing.
Why did you get reprimanded by your own apartment building?
How do we help? Put on the damn mask. If we care about doing the right things, I wear a mask for you as much as I wear it for me. I had the disease. You need to wear a damn mask.
Right.
And you have to take care of other people in your community, and it's got to be about us because the help's not going to come from above.
The CNN host, who was infected with COVID-19 earlier this year, had already been scolded by his apartment building management for not wearing a mask in common areas. In a letter wrote, "You have been observed entering and exiting the building and riding the elevator without the required face coverings. Even though staff members have asked you to comply with this requirement, you have refused to do so."
For failing to wear a mask after having been
told before.
Because I did the wrong thing.
Why won't the president adjust his messaging?
We know you broke quarantine and went to the
Hamptons. I never broke quarantine.
Everyone knows.
Chris Cuomo is a parasite on the news industry, an example of the malignant tumor eating away at real journalism. Chris Cuomo is a man who faked being under quarantine. Chris Cuomo was claiming that he was under quarantine, but was seen 30 minutes or so from his house, challenged by someone for being out of quarantine, got in his face, admitted it on his own show, and CNN is trying now to cover it up. I'm not kidding.
I never broke quarantine. You deny that happened.
Absolutely, 100%.
And then you came home and you pretended to rise up from your basement like Lazarus, even though you had already broken
quarantine.
Listen,
you want to mock my getting sick.
COVID positive.
You want to mock my getting sick, you can.
I'm not mocking you getting sick.
Of course
sick.
You are.
I'm pointing
of
out that you broke
are.
Quarantine and went I out never to your place at the Hamptons while you were COVID
and
positive.
And you know it. I never
and now
did.
Now you're going to lecture me about
I'm not
who
lecturing
obeys
you.
What rules?
Look, you want me to be the story.
Like
you want my brother to be the story because you can't handle Trump.
So yeah, Chris Cuomo ignored the same quarantine he's forcing on other people. Yeah, he went outside. Yeah, he works out and sweats a lot. Got something to say about that? What are you going to do about it, huh? Come on, tough guy. What are you going to do?
Look at the numbers were supposed to disappear.
I have just told you what the president's accomplishments on this
what?
Are.
What? The travel ban?
This from the very beginning.
Then
all of this, remember,
why are we
this
in
is
such
a novel
bad shape?
Virus. Chris.
Why are we in such
this
bad shape?
This had never
shape?
Been seen. The testing regime had to be created from nothing, and now we lead the world in testing.
You do
the
not lead the world in testing.
Partnership on this,
you do not
the
lead the world in testing, and the president says
absolutely.
Testing is the problem.
The development of the therapeutics. And
the
we are
president
this close
says
to vaccine,
testing
and Joe
is the
Biden
problem.
Is trying to scare people away from taking the vaccine, Chris. That is politically
no,
reckless.
No, he isn't.
He's playing politics
he
with
said,
people's
I
life.
Won't trust Trump.
Is.
Trump.
Every time he talks about the vaccine, he downplays it and discourages people from
because
taking it.
Because the president is grossly
when says,
exaggerating when it will be ready.
Go. That is absolutely politicizing a vaccine.
The
that
president
will save millions
says
of lives
we are around the corner from a cure, and that is
and
a material deception. It's a material
it
deception.
Is. You cannot defend that. Both Joe Biden
I don't have
and
to
Kamala
defend
Harris
it.
Have politicized
this is about
the
your campaign
issue,
and what the president has said
why
to do. Go ahead.
Well, I missed that last part because you were shouting.
This is about I'm
Joe
shouting.
Biden and Kamala
this
Harris,
is about
every,
the president's campaign.
Every step of the way. Yeah, and we reserve the right to talk about our opponent in this race from time to time.
You should.
Time,
I'm letting
Chris.
You. Why do you think if I had you, would, you on? Your good
that's
looks?
That's what I'm attempting to do. Joe Biden, every step yeah. of this way, unburdened, by the way, unburdened by the responsibility of leadership, has done nothing from the very beginning except politicize this. He did it with the virus itself.
And what has
He's
the president
doing it
now done, with
Tim? The vaccine.
What has it's the president very, done?
I have
he held
you want
a
me
super.
To run down the list
he held
again?
No,
it
because the
with
list
the
is
stopping
the,
of travel the, from China
the,
in January,
that was
which
very
Joe
months
Biden
ago.
Would not have done.
The country
and then
is
the
in the
incredible,
worst
unprecedented
shape
ramping
it's
up
been.
Of the private sector and the federal
it
government.
It is not
to
unprecedented. He found one company in Maine.
Absolutely.
He found one company in Maine.
Detroit's automakers have produced personal protective equipment such as gowns, masks, face shields, and respirators.
In Maine.
GM once said it will continue to produce face masks and N95 respirators at a facility in Warren for the foreseeable future to support needs in its plants and in its communities. Although COVID-19 treatment more recently has trended away from incubating patients on ventilators, more than 1,200 from the automakers have been sent to public health jurisdictions in Arizona, California, Illinois, Indiana, and Texas.
All right, you know him for his pillows, but Mike Lindell wants to have you know him, at least in the near future, for his face mask, because he is trying to make sure that he can make as many as possible.
We converted in 3 days a 200,000 square foot factory. I've got about 300 or 400 of my workers converted over, and we're up to 10,000 masks a day, and I want to get up to 50,000 by next week.
In Maine, absolutely to do PPE. Tim, look, I gave you a chance to put your arguments out there into the ether.
That is absolutely absurd.
We'll let people do the fact check for themselves.
The involvement, using the Defense Production Act to involve the private sector.
Tim, look, I hear your arguments.
If you want to be a Joe Biden surrogate, I'm sure there are still hiring over there.
You guys can play that game. You can take a shot at my brother.
You missed your chance.
You can take a shot at me.
You would have fit right in at the debate.
Listen,
you could have had another podium on stage and won the debate.
Tim, listen. I respect your efforts because that's the game. You want to go at Andrew, his legacy will stand for itself. His action will be judged at the ballot box. You want to come at me,
I will own any
mistake I ever make because I'm not this president and I'm not in power. But I'll tell you what, brother, in 7 days, we'll see whether people think he did the right job on this pandemic based on what you named from many months ago. We'll see. Tim Murtaugh, believe it or not, you'll be welcome back. You know why? Because here, we'll talk the talk. Yeah. You'll be welcome no matter how you play it. Take care, Tim Murtaugh.